Okay. So what I did was change the front left and right rear, because they were both the ones that were dead. Well, this one was dying and this one was dead. They were both bad from the third flight on. Then I had gears, so I figured I'd change them too. And I do have extra shafts, but I didn't change them because those look fine. And the gears are probably fine too. But I didn't change all the gears for one reason. That motor, that pinion gear was a little crunchy. So I didn't want to put a brand new gear on it. So I just left the old gear on it. And at first it was a little crunchy, but now I'm sure every single bump that has is worn into this plastic. Oh, and I changed all the bearings too. So that tightened everything up. Because the original bearings were just crap from the beginning. They were just terrible. I don't think they were ever good. So I have all new bearings, and I lubed them all up with this bearing lube that I'm almost out of that I've had for about 15 years. I don't know. I've had that forever. Lubed them all up with that. All new gears except this one. I'll put the white props on the front. And what I got a whole bunch of those little... I'm gonna go to nylon. I don't know where I put them. I'm gonna go to nylon or plastic, or whatever they are, pinions. I'll let these motors go till they wear out. Then I got some spare motors that are cheap, and I'll put pinions on them, scavenge the connectors off of these motors, and then I'll change this gear out. Should be good. And actually, you can see the difference here. I noticed another weird thing about this. If you tighten these up too much, some of them, you can tighten them up, squeeze these together, tighten them up, and it's fine. Some of them, if you tighten it up just a little bit too much, it'll cause some drag. And I'm not sure if it's just squeezing this, or if it's squeezing it together, and the drag is being caused on this... on the shaft connected to that bearing or what. But some of these you have to be real careful. If you do just a little bit too much, it will cause a bunch of drag. And they seem to be tightened even if you just tighten those up a little bit. Check this out. No drag there. No drag there. This one, no drag here, and that one's good. No major drag there. I imagine if people tighten these up and there's some drag, I bet you that'll kill the motor pretty quick too. So I'm trying to figure out where the CG is so I can get it right for when I put my own batteries in here, which are a little bit longer. It seems like the CG is right about there when I put this battery in its stock location. And in between the front and rear props is a little bit forward of that by a few millimeters. It's just about right there. And with that battery in its stock location, the CG is back here. And I don't know if that, you know, it's supposed to be up here, or it's designed to be a little bit further back. Hard to say. I would imagine it would be, you know, it's supposed to be right in the middle. So anyways, that's why I took this little notch out. This thing's so tight, it doesn't matter what I take out. It's just hard to even get in and out of there. These I run about like that. And that seems to, I mean, these cords are longer, so who knows. So this thing's running really good now. I've just done a few flights indoors. You know, it'll hands off hover. It has lots of power all the way till the battery is quite a bit lower than it was before. And also the battery seems to last longer too. So But I'm going to test this all out. I'm sure it'll work fine. Well, I'm not totally sure. It might be completely dead. I haven't tested it, but I'm hoping it'll be okay. These are $50, $30, $50. I think you can get these cheaper than I was able to get them back then. I think, you know, I got that all at ready-made RC, which is, you know, more expensive than like the same thing at Banggood. But anyways, so here is, so here's this camera that I got. I got a couple of them actually. And this is, you got a little microphone on there. And apparently this is like either 120 or 170 degrees or something like that. And this is just a tiny little thing by itself. That camera is tiny. Then you got this thing. You know, it's just, I mean, it's got a wide angle lens. You can even tell by looking at it. Yeah, so if I can, I don't know, it's going to be hard to mount because there's, you know, on the bottom you got this stupid microphone hanging down. So that'll be cool. Yeah, that's a good comparison. Looks like it might be even smaller than this little guy. Yeah, it looks like it might even be, it's got a bunch of Velcro on it, but focus. Yeah, see, it's even smaller than that. I mean, especially because it doesn't have a case on it. It's just, you know, I don't know if I can just glue something on there to make it mountable somehow. I don't know, but that's a neat little camera. It's only like $9. You know, it probably took forever to get here. I can't remember. I don't think it was quick.